Bonjour tout le monde. Hello everyone. Since the beginning of the crisis, our government has been focused on keeping Canadians safe and making sure people are supported during this challenging time. And as we move into the summer, this work continues. While we've made good progress over the past few months, the virus remains a very serious threat to our health. And with parts of the economy shut down for many months, a lot of people need help getting back on their feet. So we're going to continue helping in every way we can. Our government has launched new programs and made new investments to help businesses reopen safely, get people back on the job, and lay the groundwork for our economy to come roaring back. If you own a business and you're struggling with cash flow, you can get a loan through the Canada Emergency Business Account to bridge to better times. If you're a student or a recent grad looking for a job, we've created thousands of new work placements through Canada Summer Jobs and the Student Work Placement Program. And if you're an employer and you need help to bring back your staff, the Canada Emergency Wage Subsidy is there for you through this summer. In every part of the country, business owners are stepping up and hiring back their staff, from Brook Signs in Brantford, Ontario, to Anchor D Guiding and Outfitting in Turner Valley, Alberta. And moving forward, our government will help even more businesses bring back their workers. La vie commence tranquillement à reprendre son cours depuis quelques semaines, et c'est une bonne nouvelle pour nous tous. Mais la reprise présente aussi des nouveaux défis. Notre gouvernement continue de suivre la situation de près et d'être à l'écoute des Canadiens. On veut que les programmes soient adaptés aux besoins et aux réalités des gens. C'est donc pourquoi le gouvernement fédéral entend prolonger d'un mois l'aide d'urgence du Canada pour le loyer commercial et on travaille avec les provinces et les territoires pour y arriver. Le programme permet présentement à des milliers de petites entreprises à travers le pays de payer moins cher en loyer. On comprend que beaucoup de propriétaires ont des problèmes de liquidité en ce moment et on travaille là-dessus cette semaine. The federal government intends to extend the Canada Emergency Commercial Rent Assistance by another month, and we're working with the provinces and territories to do just that. This program is helping thousands of small businesses across the country save on rent. We know that many business owners are struggling with cash flow right now, so we're working on a solution. With summer officially here, I know a lot of people are wondering what to expect for the coming months. So this afternoon, Dr. Tam and Dr. New will release the latest public health modeling. We'll have more details then, but here's the main takeaway from these projections. After a very challenging spring, things are continuing to move in the right direction. We still have some hot spots in some parts of the country, but nationally, the number of cases, hospitalizations, and deaths is declining over time. And that's because Canadians are doing their part. You took this seriously. You followed public health instructions and made sacrifices so we could get this virus under control. Over the coming weeks, we're going to keep regularly updating Canadians on how this virus is progressing, as we have since the beginning of this crisis, including with the latest numbers continuing to be published every single day. As we move into this new phase, however, Dr. Tam, Dr. New, and I will provide an update on the pandemic a few times a week instead of every day when we have briefings or information to share. I want to stress, though, that while we're on the right track, the fight against COVID-19 is not over yet. As we start to reopen parts of the economy, we must continue to follow local public health guidelines to keep each other safe. Cet après-midi, la Dr. Tam et le Dr. New vont dévoiler les dernières projections de santé publique. On aura plus de détails à ce moment-là, mais voici ce qu'il faut retenir. Après un printemps très difficile, les choses continuent de s'améliorer. On a des zones chaudes, mais dans l'ensemble du pays, le nombre de cas d'hospitalisation et de décès est en baisse. Et c'est parce que les Canadiens font leur part. Vous avez pris la situation au sérieux en suivant les directives de santé publique et en faisant des sacrifices. Au cours des prochaines semaines, on va continuer de vous tenir au courant des derniers développements, comme on le fait depuis le début. Les dernières données sur la COVID-19 continueront d'être publiées à tous les jours. Mais étant donné qu'on entre dans cette nouvelle phase, la Dr Tam, le Dr New et moi allons tenir des points de presse sur la pandémie quelques fois par semaine, mais pas tous les jours. Je veux être très clair, par contre. On a fait des progrès importants, mais on n'est pas sorti du bois. On doit demeurer prudent et continuer de suivre les directives des experts. With Canada Day right around the corner, we have another busy week ahead of us. In addition to our ongoing response to COVID-19, the new NAFTA will come into force on Wednesday. With trade between NAFTA members valued at nearly $1.5 trillion in 2018, we can't overstate how vital it is to maintain free and fair trade between our three countries. Millions of jobs depend on a strong and stable relationship with our partners. This deal secures access to the North American market for our business owners, entrepreneurs, and consumers. It removes uncertainty for our manufacturers, our investors, and our workers. This deal is good for Canada and good for Canadians.